dark times, crime is on the rise. Stealing and drug dealing is at an all-time high. The government is failing to solve the problems. Society is in decline. Young people are being tagged as hoodies, labeled this by a society who has given up fighting to help them. These hoodies seem to be a massive problem in estates all over the country. But society is too quick to label. Are there really heroes out there who we perceive as villains?
Society.
Today are very aggressive, and I find you feel very intimidating when you're walking past them.
And we go a little something like this. Hit it. Hi, Nick. Come on. Cold, cooling at a bar, and I'm looking for some action. But like Mick Jagger said, I can't get no satisfaction. The girls are all around, but none of them want to get with me. My threads are fresh, and I'm looking.
Fatality.
So Jack, what do you know about the drug dealing that's been going on?
I'm not really into drugs myself, but I've seen the consequences. A few of my mates.
So you've got nothing to do with it then, none of the dealing?
No.
What about the shoplifting? You've had a lot of visits to the shoplifting lately.
I'm very good friends with the shopkeeper, Cheryl.
So you don't do drugs, you're not involved in shoplifting. Alcohol, you drink much, or you don't look old enough to
now drink? Now and then on the weekends, yeah.
Was that last slide?
How old are you?
18.
Didn't look 18, is he?
No.
I think that's just us getting older.
So what do you do in the evenings then, if you're not involved in any drugs, drinking, what do you actually do?
Well, I work a lot of the nights, and some nights I like to play football down at the Betis football clubs, 5-a-side tournaments. that's on a Friday night. So.
Cool. Who do you do that with?
A lot of my friends from Gaer, about my age.
How else do you contribute to your community then as a young person?
I'm sort of a neutral citizen, I'd say. Not involved in much, definitely.
Chloe, what do you know about the drug dealing going on?
Nothing
at all, no? What do you know about the shoplifting? There's been a lot of shoplifting going on lately. Do you know anything about that?
No, I haven't seen anything going down there.
So what do you do in your community then, if you're not involved in anti-social behaviour?
Come to the youth club.
What nights is that?
Monday and Wednesday.
So is there any other way you contribute to your community as a young person?
No, just like help people.
To basically stay out of trouble?
Yeah.
Katie, what do you know about the drug dealing that's been going on?
Nothing.
Don't know anything at all?
No.
Okay. Holly, we've had a lot of complaints about shoplifting. Do you know anything about the shoplifting that's been going on?
Nothing.
Nothing at all? No? Nothing to do with either of you?
No.
You're down the shops a lot. Antisocial behaviour, do you know anything about the antisocial behaviour that goes on now?
No.
Nothing at all? No?
No.
So what do you actually do in the evenings then, if you're not involved in antisocial behaviour, what do you do?
Go to your floor and youth club.
One night a day?
And there's youth club on Monday and Wednesday, and youth forum on Tuesday.
Do you do anything else to be a good young person in the community?
Fundraising.
What type of fundraising?
Planting seeds, like little
people. Tesco's.
Tesco's like backpacking, that sort of stuff.
Two good eggs, you know, I reckon, Dean? Two good eggs. Ryan Hammond. We've got you, Ryan. We've got you.
For what?
For shoplifting.
Got evidence?
We have got evidence. We've got a person next door we've been interviewing for the past 3 hours. And finally, after much interrogation, she finally gave us your name.
No comment, then.
I just tell you that we got someone next door who's grassed you up and you've got nothing to say.
Look, Ryan, we got some hard evidence against you. We know it's you, like...
Like what? Why haven't you got against me?
Ryan, like I just said, buddy, okay? The reason that you're here is because someone has grassed you up.
But why would I want to rob somewhere where I live near?
My client is well within his rights not to say anything.
It's easier if you just answer the questions.
I got nothing to admit, I didn't do nothing. Now you got my fingerprints on me on CCTV, then there we go, but we haven't. So you can't actually tell it's me.
We know that you've shoplifted before. Someone has just said that you've shoplifted again. Why shouldn't we just arrest you now?
We've got her statement.
Her statement?
She's next door now. She's been here for hours. And we talked to her like we're talking to you, with a solicitor sat there. We questioned her, and after a couple of hours, fair play, she took a while, but finally she gave us your name.
Submit she was.
Exactly, submit she was. Eventually she grassed up. This is it, this is going to be the end of the interview. If you don't want to admit to doing it now, we're going to arrest you, because we've got someone next door who claimed that you were shoplifting with her, okay? So we're going to arrest you, we're going to read you your rights now, and that's it, game over then, okay?
Yeah.
Finally, the cops got their man. But what did we learn? Did we learn that not all young people are bad? That some are actually good? We shouldn't judge a book by its cover. Society needs to look at young people and realize not all of them commit crimes. That some actually help their community.
my view at the moment is that there's mixed quality amongst young people. You've got some that are excellent, and you've got others that need educational standards raising and being taught how to behave. They are the people that in the minority that cause the antisocial behaviour problems on this estate.
This estate, like estates all over the country, has its problems. But there are a chosen few who fight for what's right. Who fight to turn young people away from the dark and show them what they can achieve. These young people have our futures in their hands. These young people have become heroes.